take my suitcase down like prom night. Tossing memories, socks, thoughts who pretend to be boxer briefs, pants, pictures of frenemies. Shoot me to make room, room, room for the life. Lately I've been cut the cord to my fun.
Tip-off goes to Seattle. Now let's take a look at the Sonics opening lineup. We've got Hawkins. Sean Kemp is out there with Schrempf. Then there's Peyton. And it's Cauley Stein in at the five down low. Now here's Peyton. No good from Schrempf. Collins with it. Now Peyton defending. 76ers moving the ball around. Schrempf against Irving. And McGinnis kicks to Irving. Six to shoot. Over Schrempf. It's hauled in by Hawkins. Peyton outside. It's Schrempf on the wing. Misses the three. Carroll with the ball for Philadelphia. We play just over a minute here in the first. In the corner, Collins with it. Carroll with a screen for Collins. That misses, so no good on his first attempt of the night. And there's the pass to Hawkins. Peyton against Bibby. Cauley Stein with a screen on Bibby. Down low, here's Schrempf. That's in, coming off an assist from Peyton.
Oh, about time. Starting to wonder a bit if they were ever gonna knock a shot down.
Here's Irving. Softly drops in the floater.
Boy, that's beautiful touch on the floater. And let's remember, not everyone has that shot in their arsenal.
Peyton passes to Schrempf. Cauley Stein. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Nice work inside by Cauley Stein. Great tools as a finisher.
Bibby kicks to Collins. It's Irving, top of the key. Rebound by the Sonics. To the right side. Here's Peyton. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. 76ers trailing. Bibby with it. Out defended by Cauley Stein. Passes it to McGinnis. Over Peyton. Shot from the low block. It's taken away by Peyton. Throws it up high. It's tipped. It's stolen by Carroll. Kicks to Bibby. Pass to Irving. To the paint. Here's McGinnis, and two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot. And there's the foul against Seattle. This is his first free throw of the game.
George McGinnis at the line for two.
Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. The Sonics leading. To the inside, Hawkins. Collins grabs the miss.
Well, we didn't see the same kind of control we're used to seeing from him. This guy is usually a tremendous finisher.
The pass to McGinnis. Bibby with it. The three. It's deflected. Payton looking it over. Back to Schrempf. Kempa screen on Collins. Here's Schrempf. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Yeah, and the size of Schrempf there makes it difficult on the D, really forcing them to have to foul on the way up.
Seattle shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line. The free throw drops for Schrempf. And Schrempf drops them both. The 76ers trail by three. Bibby kicks to Collins. Irving up top. Back to Collins. Irving up top. Schrempf cover. And the rejection by Cauley Stein.
You better come stronger than that. Cauley Stein, a presence defensively.
Payton drives in, and it's blocked. Irving looking over the floor. Collins passes it to Irving. Back to Collins. There's a screen over Cauley Stein. No good on the shot, a bit long that time. And here's Payton. He'll bring it up with the Supersonics. Schrempf dishes to Payton. Back to Schrempf. Kemp inside. He's guarded by Collins. That's good from Kemp on the assist by Schrempf.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
Bibby kicks to Collins. It's Carroll on the wing. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Shot clock at six. Irving can't get it to go.
I'll tell you, it's been a struggle for him in this period, and they're struggling as a result.
Here's Payton. Off target at the rim.
Great rim protection to prevent him from converting. Beautiful.
Here's Carroll. Cauley Stein with the defensive effort. Sonics leading by five. Payton in the corner. And he lobs it up toward the rim. It's stolen by Carroll. Irving with the ball. Now defended by Cauley Stein.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
Hawkins kicks to Payton. To the middle. Here's Cauley Stein.
Cauley Stein, a tremendous athlete and a dynamic finisher.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here.
Trying to snap them out of this little slump.
Just feels like the basket is looking awfully small to them right now. They're having a hard time getting anything to fall.
score right now. It's your Sixers 10 piece.
Changes for Philadelphia. Dawkins checked in for McGinnis. Mix comes in for Irving. And Freeze subbed in for Bibby. Then for the Supersonics, Sam Perkins. He's checked in for Cauley Stein. Parker comes in for Detlef Schrempf. And McMillan subbed in for Hawkins. Free. Back to Carroll. Outside Collins. Six on the shot clock. The 76ers need to get off a shot. Dawkins. It's hauled in by the Sonics.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Payton outside, fires the three, drills it from outside.
Gary Payton.
And now it's a 10-point Sonic lead.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Here's Free, passes it to Dawkins, and stolen by Perkins. And there's the feed to Kemp. It's hauled in by Nix.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Driving the lane. They grab their own miss. To stop the drought. Free can't get it to go. And here's Payton. He'll bring it up with the Supersonics. The screen from Kemp.
Really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
Alphonso McKinney's checked in for Chief. The Supersonics also with the sub. Bell's checked in.
Coming onto the floor for the away team.
The 76ers trail by 10. Left side Collins. Over McMillan. Here's Dawkins. Second chance shot. He takes it up and lays it in.
Well, just it's easy to say this guy wanted it more. Creating the second chance opportunity and cashing in.
Parker, a screen on Free. Here's Payton. Here's Pell. He can't get that one. Now the 76ers take it the other way. Pass to Dawkins. 76ers moving the ball around. Collins passes it to Free. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. And the pass to McMillan. It's blocked. They recover it. Payton against Free. Pass to Mix. Here's McKinney. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Dawkins, a screen on McMillan. They swipe it. Here's Payton. A shot off that time. Collins with some nice D.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly.
Out to the wing. Here's Mix. McKinney passes to Collins. Down to five on the shot clock. Over McMillan. It's tipped. And that's out of bounds. Philadelphia will retain possession. We have got to see that sensational mobile one block again.
Sharp instincts on D there. Just timing. When to rise up and swat that one away.
And Philadelphia has possession. 3-point game.
So just a little too physical out there right now. That's already his second foul.
Hawkins checked in for Gary Payton.
Checking in for the away team, Percy Hawkins.
McMillan against Free. It's tipped, and it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here.
Sixers ball.
Here's Free. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. There's 1:54 left in the first quarter of the game. McMillan against Collins. Can they get it? And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
Seattle shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Nate McMillan, two shots.
That's good from McMillan. He hits both from the stripe. 1:41 left to play in the first quarter. Free passes to Collins. Here's Dawkins. And it's Seattle with the rebound.
Well, this has not been a quarter to remember for this guy. He looks completely flustered.
Hawkins against Free. Hawkins passes to McMillan. Five on the clock. Perkins with a screen on Collins. Here's McMillan. The Sonics again can't hit.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Stripped away. It's 2-on-1. Here's Hawkins. The jumper buried by the Hawk. Percy Hawkins.
And out front early, limiting the opposition offensively.
Pass to Mix. Excellent D there from Parker. Sonics leading by 10. 32 seconds left to play here in the first. McMillan kicks to Hawkins. Pocket 6. Seattle needs to get off a shot. The 19-foot shot. That one off the back iron and out. Here's Mix, covered by Perkins. Inside. Pass to Mix. There's the three. And no good on the last second attempt this time. And so it's Seattle going into the break with a 10-point lead. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stance for Seattle?
Well, in the first half of play, they're closing out aggressively, blocking shots, a key indicator of their activity on the defensive side.
And you know, the other thing they've done really well tonight is stay active defensively. Lots of steals, and that's making a huge difference.
The 76ers trail by 10, and now brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. On the court right now for the Sonics, Schrempf is out there with Kemp, and it's McMillan, then it's Willie Cauley-Stein, and it's Hawkins, and it's the shooting guard.
And the D getting out work there on the putback. Can't let that happen.
You have got to put a body on somebody. We talk about it ad nauseum, but you've got to be disciplined with the box outs.
Vivi against McMillan. Here's Schrempf. A three-pointer off the mark. Philadelphia with the ball. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Here's Irving. Schrempf with the rebound. Sonics leading by 8. Here's McMillan. And around a minute gone here in the second quarter. Fires for 3. A long-range bomb from Schrempf.
And Detlef is one of the best at filling it up from deep. Just possesses great height and that high release point.
Hawkins against Irving. Bibby passes to McGinnis. Outside Irving. Bryan up top. Schrempf covered. Ball stolen. Into the lane. And it's McMillan missing. And it's Irving with the ball for the 76ers. They trail by 11. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
That's his second personal foul. First team foul.
76ers have converted 1 of 2 free throws so far today.
Taking 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
First one falls for. Peyton, he's checked in for Seattle. And so he makes both from the line.
And that's the norm for him. He's pretty much automatic when he's at the line.
Here's the lob to the hoop. Kemp finishes the back end of the alley-oop.
Oh, beautiful setup there. One thing you can say about Kemp, no pass is too high for him to go get.
Outside Irving. Here's McGinnis. And the rejection by Cauley-Stein. It's Schrempf on the wing. That's good. And it's Peyton with the assist.
4-3.
Peyton's got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight.
You simply must play better defense than that. This guy is too good from distance.
Now here's Bryant. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Now the pass to Irving. Shot clock at 5. The rejection by Cauley-Stein, and he recovers it, and there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Seattle leading by 14. Peyton outside. Over Irving. The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
I'd say you have to body him up, but who has the body to keep Kemp from getting where he wants to go?
Outside Irving. Looking to end the run. And the rejection by Cauley-Stein. McMillan against Irving. Pass to Peyton. Lets the 3 fly. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Irving's got 6 rebounds in the game.
And he's trying to shoot his way out of it. You know, they have the lead, but honestly, I think it might help if he'd be a little bit more selective tonight.
Peyton with the ball. He's picked up by Irving. Payton passes to McMillan. Irving against Payton. Passes it to Schrempf. Puts up a three. That's good. And it's Payton with the assist. Payton's got five assists in the game.
Yet another three. Once we hit the second quarter, it just seems as if those threes just started to fall like raindrops.
All right, coming up to the court right now, it's your Sixers dance team.
Bibby against Payton. Bibby passes to Irving. Over McMillan. That doesn't go in either for Irving.
Solid rebound there. And with the score like it is, that's an area where they can't afford to get lazy.
McMillan kicks to Payton. Cauley-Stein with a screen on Bibby. Just five on the clock. The shot by Payton, no good.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
And this is where you hope that he can find something easy so he can see the ball go through the net.
Now, here is Irving. Bryant with it. Now defended by Cauley-Stein. And it's Bryant missing.
No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
And I think you can start to feel their frustration mounting. With every missed bucket, it becomes more and more desperate.
Bibby passes to Irving. Here's McGinnis. They could use a bucket. And the rejection by Cauley-Stein.
Away team foul. Willie Cauley-Stein. That's his first.
And this is his
foul.
Second trip to the line
second
tonight.
Team foul.
At the line for Philadelphia, George McGinnis. At the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Greg, playing most of your career in the 90s, the game has really changed. Less physical, more skilled, but what role has the league played in all of that change?
Well, the NBA is at the forefront of these changes. The competition committee that they have that meets annually to discuss ways to try to improve the game. Listen, they're not going to always knock it out of the park, but you have to keep thinking forward. And I applaud the league for their attempts to try to improve this game. And growth and working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
McMillan passes to Payton. Good on the three-point shot. Payton's got six points.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
Now, here is Irving. The dish now to Bibby. And McGinnis kicks to Irving. Trying to break that ice-cold streak. Another shot. It's hauled in by the Sonics. Outside Kemp. Bibby against Payton. Here's Shrimp. And that one is stuffed right through.
Yeah, just a simple one-hand flush.
I think he got a few more inches on his vertical by going with the spike. Knocked away. McMillan against Irving. Here's McMillan. Payton outside. Payton makes another fantastic move.
Yeah, they're rolling right now. That lead continues to grow.
And one of the things that's helped that is they're getting it done on both ends. Terrific focus on offense, and they're locked in defensively.
The 76ers again can't hit it. Seattle with the ball. They're on a 20-4 run. It's blocked. And that goes out of bounds. Last touch by Carroll. Sun changes for Philadelphia. Knicks comes in for Bryant. And Free subbed in for Irving. And Seattle also making a change. Parker's checked in for Shrimp. Off the inbound. Payton passes to Cauley-Stein. Here's World B Free. They get the rebound. Here's McGinnis. And the rejection by Cauley-Stein.
This is a quarter he'd rather forget. This guy just can't seem to get the lid off of that bucket.
The screen from Kemp. Here's Payton. Carroll with the rebound.
This shot's just, it's not there right now. With his team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
Just can't find a shot. It's no wonder they're losing. I mean, he's been completely scoreless all night.
Parker passes to Payton. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Payton's got 7 points here in this quarter.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Here's Free. Can they get it? That's tipped.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up.
And it's Kemp slamming it down.
And how sweet a play was that?
As sweet as it gets. An exquisite pass to set up the powerful alley-oop dunk.
Your Sixers bad team.
Some changes. Dawkins checked in for McGinnis. Alfonso McKinney comes in for T. And Collins subbed in for Bibby. And Seattle also making a change. Hawkins is checked in. Kemp against Free. Here's Dawkins. The 76ers with another miss. Payton against Free. Kemp a screen on Free. Here's Payton. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Payton's got 12 points in the game.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
And out of bounds as the Sonics gain possession.
Ball goes to the away team.
And a quick look at how the Supersonics schedule is shaping up. On Saturday, they'll go back home and they'll be hosting the Detroit Pistons. And then on Monday, Seattle dictating the flow. Only given up six here in this quarter. Pass to Hawkins. And here's Kemp. He's got eight. Payton outside. Five to shoot. Over Free. A shot by Payton. No good.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Here's the screen. Outside Collins. The pass to Dawkins. And stolen by Payton. They push it up, four on three. And he's going up for the alley-oop. And Cauley Stein throws it down.
Just throw it up there. Trill Will's going to take care of the rest.
Free against Payton. Kept alive. Here's Dawkins. Stripped it away. Payton left side from downtown. And another three for Seattle.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
And stolen by Payton. And here we go. Fast break. Payton's got it. Makes it off the glass. Payton's got 17 now.
Well, they're leading in large part because of the work he's put in this quarter. This is nicely done.
Free passes to Dawkins. Outside Collins. Four on the clock. Trying to get something going. No good. Good D by Parker. For the 76ers, the last game, a win against Detroit. It's Cauley Stein, top of the key. Parker finds Payton. Driving in. And it's good on the assist by Parker.
The assist goes to...
Parker's got four assists now tonight.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Now, here's Collins. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. The shot by Dawkins is no good. And here's Payton. He'll bring it up for Seattle. Here's Parker. It's hauled in by Mix. Mix has got five rebounds tonight. Pass to Free. Here's McKinney. Collins looking around. They set the pick. And Parker with the block. 6 second difference between shot and game clock. Hawkins shot good.
And a well-decorated college player, largely for his ability to fill it up from distance. Hawkins pure on that one.
Payton against Free. To the middle. Shot to stop the run. No good there.
He's done a dynamite job rebounding the basketball. And no issues fighting it out against the big guys down low.
And so it's Seattle, able to put on a show for the ages. Their defense has been active and effective. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Hello, everybody. We're here to break it all down, and through the first half of play, it's a very commanding lead.
And the game plan they went with was very clear. It was centered around scoring inside. Pound that ball inside, pound it in the paint, try to get the high percentage shot. And because of this assertive attitude, They've got the edge where it counts on the scoreboard.
Let's move on to see what's coming up on the schedule.
And for that game against the Pistons, they really should have an advantage heading into this one. But hey, stranger things have happened. The league is unpredictable. Pretty much anyone can win at any time.
That'll do it for our show tonight. Thanks for joining us, and we'll send you back to Kevin Harlan for more Hoops action.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. It's been one outstanding game so far from Gary Payton.
And if he can keep shooting from deep like he did in the first half, he's going to be more than a handful.
What I love is they've continued to feed this guy, ride the hot hand until the defense does something about it.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. We've got McGinnis. Irving is out there with T. Then it's Collins. And it's Bibby in at the point. That's the group on the four for Philadelphia. Knocks it loose. That's out of bounds. Seattle will retain possession.
Away team ball.
Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile one block.
And this is how you protect and grow a lead, by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
One item that stood out, their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it makes it really hard to defend.
Now here's Payton, 19 points in the game. Oh, and there's the alley-oop, and Cauley Stein throws it down.
Chemistry at its best, an unreal alley-oop.
You're right, the pass, the catch, the dunk, all of it perfect. Here's Collins. No points in the game yet for him. Shrimp with the steal. Hawkins with it. He's picked up by Collins. Payton right side. Over Bibby. No good from Payton. They've been a little too casual with the ball out there.
Yeah, but you can't force that square peg into the round hole. Oftentimes, you just got to make that first simple pass and get a rhythm from that.
Now, here is Bibby after the miss from Gary Payton. Six to shoot. Here's Bibby. No good on the shot. Seattle goes the other way with it. Payton outside. Cauley Stein with the screen for Payton. It's Shrimp on the wing. He's looking for Carroll and finds him. Passes it to Bibby. Now Irving. Carroll passes to Collins. Pass to McGinnis. Here's Irving. Shrimp cover. No good from Irving.
Listen, that's a look he can hit, but right now he can't throw it in the ocean.
Payton passes to Hawkins. Bibby against Payton. He feeds it to Cauley Stein.
76ers foul. George McGinnis.
And Seattle making a change here. Perkins has checked in.
First team foul. Substitution for the away team, Sam Perkins.
Bibby against Payton.
76ers foul, George McGinnis. That's his second personal foul, second team foul.
Little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. No good from Payton. And it's the 76ers with the ball. They're scoreless since the first half. Bibby kicks to Irving. Carroll passes to Collins. Shot clock at 6. Over Hawkins. Collins, good. Collins has got his first 2 points of the night.
They seem to concede that shot, and his response is, thank you very much.
Up top, Hawkins. He's guarded by Collins. Perkins trying to break loose. Payton's shot is off. And it's the 76ers with the ball. They've only allowed 2 points so far here in the second half.
I'll tell you, that vertical ability he has puts him in select company in NBA power forwards. May not have great size, but boy, he plays bigger than it.
And it's the Supersonics with the ball. Philadelphia getting their last shot to go. Payton against Carroll. Payton can't get it to go. And it's Carroll with the ball for the Philadelphia 76ers. Knocked loose and stolen by Payton. Irving against Shrimp. There's the pass to Payton. And they double up Payton. Six on the shot clock. Kicks it out to Hawkins. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton. Payton's got his ninth assist in the game now.
There you go again. A nice kick out after the D had collapsed on it.
Bibby passes to Collins. Wants to get it to Irving and does. To the inside. Looking to get back on track here. Nice D from Shrimp.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Up top, Hawkins, a three ball, and another three for Seattle.
And he found the perfect spot behind the arc there. Big gap in the deep.
Outside, Collins. McGinnis with the screen on Hawkins. Collins, two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And guys, his speed and quickness and just a relentless nature of Doug Collins. Very hard for any defender to keep up with.
And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Seattle.
We've seen them make the extra effort from a defensive standpoint, closing out airspace and sending shots back.
They've gotten out on the break over and over tonight as well. A lot of baskets coming in transition.
And the first one at the line is good for the Sonics. Pels checked in. And McMillan subbed in for Gary Payton. So he gets them both. Here's McMillan. Pass to Hawkins. Shrimp a screen on Collins. Here's Hawkins. Shrimp kicks to Perkins. Sam Perkins knocking down the three.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thank you, guys. We have seen today's athletes taking stands for social justice. All-star Bradley Beal says, "We understand there will be a backlash, but we don't care about that. I'm a human being, a citizen, just like everybody else. I have family and friends still living in those environments. I'm their voice." Kevin?
All right, David, thank you very much. McMillan can't make it work. Here's Philadelphia. Irving kicks to Bibby. Irving against Shrimp. The floater, a nice shot by Irving. Irving's got six.
And his presence as a scorer, it just has a calming effect for the rest of the team. He's a fallback option whenever they need one.
Hawkins against Collins. Hawkins with it. 10 points for him. Pocket six. Shrimp a screen on Bibby. Leaner from distance. McMillan can't make it work.
And whether he's a great off-balance shooter or not, the lean is probably not the best option on that shot.
Well, that's not the guy you want guarding him at the rim. Just too much of a differential in terms of size.
Here's McMillan. 76ers getting the bucket. Perkins with a screen on Bibby. Got a piece of it. And now Philadelphia on the break. Feeds to Collins. The rebound by Pell. Here's McMillan. There's the screen. Passes to Hawkins. Shot clock at 6. Shrimp a screen on Bibby. Here's Hawkins. Seattle missing again. To the paint. And they're moving it up. And here we go. Sam Perkins getting it to go.
And I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen tonight. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively, turning into easy points.
Fades back. It's hauled in by the Sonics. Perkins got 4 rebounds in this game. Bibby against McMillan. Pass to Shrimp. Jacks up a 3. It's hauled in by McGinnis. McGinnis has got 6 rebounds in the game. Bibby passes to McGinnis. Over Perkins. McGinnis' shot is off. And here are the Supersonics now. Now Hawkins. He's got 10. Here's McMillan. He kicks it to Shrimp. Just 5 to shoot. From outside, off the mark. And here's Collins. He'll bring it up for Philadelphia. Here's McGinnis, and McGinnis throws it down.
There is an imagination, a creativity. This guy's passing drives the offense.
Shrimp a screen on Bibby. McMillan against Bibby. The pass to Shrimp. Over Irvin. And the basket by Shrimp. Shrimp's got 17.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
It's Irving, top of the key. Hawkins against Collins. Bibby up top. Pass to Irving. And it's Seattle with the rebound. Perkins got his 6th rebound on the night.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Some nice ball movement here by Seattle. McMillan can't make it work.
Boy, he can't buy a bucket. Shut out completely so far, and yet they're still ahead.
Passes it to Collins. Here's Irving. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Irving against McMillan. Back to Shrimp. Over Bibby. Rebound by the 76ers.
You know what? Just a little fancy on that possession there. Just go up in rhythm.
Collins dishes to Carroll. On the wing, Irving. Shrimp covering. No good from Irving.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Well, not at the offensive end, certainly. He cannot buy a bucket right now.
Now here's Perkins. 7-foot shot. It's hauled in by McGinnis. McGinnis has got his 8th rebound here tonight. Here's McMillan. Out to Shrimp. Here's the 3. Doesn't go for him. And Philadelphia the other way now.
He started out strong. 3 threes in the first half, but the long ball has disappeared on him since.
Pass to Irving. The feed to Carroll over Schrempf. Another miss by Philadelphia. And it's the Supersonics with the ball. Here's McMillan. The pass to Schrempf. Now Hawkins. Six to shoot. Here's McMillan. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
That's his second personal foul.
He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here.
At the line for the away team, Nate McMillan. At the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. 6 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's World Be Free. And no luck with that time on the buzzer beater. And so it's Seattle holding an unbelievable lead as the quarter wraps up. They've had active hands and have forced a lot of turnovers in this one. And don't go away. We'll be right back. And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
And when you're the beneficiary of a pass that good, you better deliver. And he did just that.
And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest. So with Payton on the bench, here's the group that George Karl has on the floor. We've got Askew, Parker out there with Burkowski. Then it's Miller. Here is Burkowski. And the layup falls. Burkowski's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for Seattle.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Dawkins, good.
And no matter what they've tried, the D just has not been able to deny them the ball inside.
Pass to Askew. And, Greg, you were a hard-nosed defender. Would you be frustrated by what they're calling a foul today?
You know, I would based on how I played. But if you grew up in this era, this is just the way the game is. And you have to adapt and adjust. And that's what you're seeing with the players. Guys can defend it every bit as good as they ever have. In fact, I would argue they're better defensively today because they're not allowed to grab and hold. So the league is focused on offense. The fans seem to love it. But at the end of the day, you still got to get after it defensively.
And here are the Supersonics now after the Sixers pick up two. Here's Askew, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Askew's got his first bucket of the night.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
Here's Askew after the Sixers pick up two. Parker passes to Askew. Here is Burkowski, and he's covered by Dawkins. Parker right side. That one misses. Good work defensively by Bryant. Passes to Free. Down low, here's Dawkins. Rebound by Burkowski. Dawkins has gone only 4 of 11 from the field. And the dunk by Parker.
Oh, such a beautiful pass to set that one up.
Yeah, the pass might have been pretty, but the finish was angry. Pass to Dawkins. And this August, the Summer League was back in Las Vegas, Greg, and that's where you're from, that's where you played. How pleased are you to see your hometown become a mecca for the game in the offseason?
Oh, it is such a proud moment for me, born and raised here, growing up here. And quite honestly, I'm just thrilled that we have Summer League again. After what we've gone through, partner, it is just a breath of fresh air to get back to focusing on the little things.